Every living soul must one day depart this world. That is how the balance is maintained. But there are those who seek to shatter that balance. It is then that I must come down to Earth. Remember me, Detective? It is I, Death. Sorry to drop by uninvited, but I'm in dire need of your expertise. You see, a delicate balance exists between life and death. I am the one who maintains that balance. Several souls have shattered that balance by running from me when their time was due. If they do not die soon, other souls will not be born, and a rift will open in time itself. Unfortunately, they have somehow hidden themselves from me, and I cannot risk punishing an innocent soul. That is why I've come to you. You know this world well. You must not only find them, but find evidence proving their guilt. My most powerful tools are at your disposal. I see you're admiring my magic sphere. It teleports you instantly to anywhere on the globe. One soul escaped from me in Paris. I would start your search there. I'll be watching.
Not again. She ran away with that boyfriend of hers. Can't she see how dangerous Paris is now? Oh, sorry, I didn't introduce myself. I'm Gerard, and that was Zoe, my niece. Ah, you're that detective. You're investigating the missing women, yes? Everyone is leaving town because of it. It's just not safe anymore. But for some reason, Zoe won't leave. You must make her see reason. I just have this feeling that she could be next. Look, I've got to catch my train, but please take this book. I dropped a few pages in my rush, but you should be able to find them. It could help your investigation. Good luck.
Zoe, what made you decide to leave the scene at the peak of your singing career?
For so long, singing has been my life, my greatest dream. But all of that disappeared in an instant.
Did it have anything to do with your health problems?
I'll say this. There are things even more precious than passion and fame. Ah, so you're that detective. Thank you for returning my purse. I lost it during that commotion. So many people have left because of those girls who vanished. But my dear Leonard and I refuse to panic. We could never leave Paris. Ugh, you simply must meet Leonard. He'd be such a help to your investigation. You should be at home. Pardon me, I'm feeling ill.
Thank you. Greetings, Detective. Welcome to my home. I'm Leonard Gauthier. I believe you've already met my darling Zoe.
Leonard, this detective is investigating those missing women and wants to search your home for clues. I know you have nothing to hide and would be happy to help.
Certainly, my dear. I won't interfere with your investigation, Detective. I'm at your service.
Your investigation seems to be going well, Detective. I see you found the victims. Here, take my medallion. It will allow you to talk to the dead.
Basement. There's something there you need to see. And here, take this.
There once lived an orphan in Paris, but he was by no means poor. His parents had died rich, leaving him a fortune. But without anyone to love him, he grew resentful and greedy, especially when his doctors told him he did not have long to live. Young Leonard often visited his family tomb. He enjoyed walking through the dark corridors, his mind fixated on his death. One day, he discovered a diary with "For the Poor Boy" written on the cover. This diary contained terrible power. Whenever Leonard wrote a girl's name on its pages, she instantly fell in love with him, and he could drain her vitality. With these dark powers at his command, he could sustain immortality.
Thank you.
No! Leonard, is it true? Are they all dead?
They were nobody, Zoe. I've put their lives to good use. You've never tasted immortality, but I have, and it is so good.
Leonard Gaultier, you stand accused of stealing other lives to prolong your own.
Who the hell are you?
Death has come, and justice shall be done.
No one tells me what to do.
Well, my friend, but there is more work to be done.